What is the first step actually? Preferences, okay? Because we are going to solve the structural problem. Structural problem. Okay. Next, preprocessor. We're going to. Okay, now we have first the problem actually, we are taking the cantilever problem actually. Okay. Element type. Add. Then here you should take the beam element actually. Yesterday to solve the bar and truss, we are taking the link element. Okay, we are taking the link element. Now you should take the beam element. Beam. Okay, you can take the beam 188 element actually, two noded beam element. Okay. Next. What is the next step actually after knowing the element type? I don't know why. What is the element type means actually? Because before discretizations or before building any FA model, it is required actually. After knowing, next we move on to the. And the beams, real constant is not required. Why means? Because the cross section of beam may be I section, C section, rectangle sections. Okay, the separate is there here. Real constant is not required in the beams. Next, we move on to the. The metal properties given here. Now I'll hand over my session to the one of my. Mr. Eknath Mohite is there. He is working in some. Vijayawada, okay, he's going to cover these beam problems. Hello, friends, are you audible?
Sir,
after metal, first we have had the metal properties. Apply the metal properties. In that we have selected. One is structural is there. Structural, linear, in that elastic, isotropic. Give the Young's modulus of the material is 2E5. Then the Poisson's ratio is must and should be is there in beam. If you ignore in the 1D bar and 2D bar, it's okay. But in required in beams. 0.03. Okay. Sir, the parameter is wrong. The Poisson's ratio. And after that, we move sectioning. Our beam is mainly rectangle section is there.
No.
Are you audible now? All of you? Okay. In that common section is there. This is a section of our beam. If you want to change here, a subtype is there, also is there. Rectangle is there, trapezoidal is there, spherical is there, C section is there, I section is there, Z is there. Whatever you want to section is there, but we require only the rectangle is there. Rectangle beam is there.
Problem not popular.
After that we go on the sectioning is there na, our breadth of the beam.
Please all of you refer the table, the figure is there. You can help him to give the in the word is the given actually. How much the breadth and height?
In that 0.1 and height also it is a rectangle beam na? 0.1. Then we have to view preview. This is our beam. Whatever you know, and after that you have to click OK. Then just you have to click replot and everything will be similar to the graphics. After that you have to go modeling. In that you have to first create key points. last time we are selected in created node selected, but in that beam material, sorry, in beam problem, we are selected key points. Whatever it be there, will data next will be included in that in active CS. Node number 1, this is in 0. Okay. Then node number 2, the distance is
1 meter.
1 meter is there. Then
MM the code.
Difference between key point and node point.
Yes. Good question. Difference between key point and node.
Already yesterday I told friends, I think you were absent. Okay. There are two types of models are there in the design. One is the geometric model, another one is FEA model. Okay, if you create the first four options, if you use the first four options, key point, line, area and volume. Okay, then what are the model you are developing using the software? That is called as a geometry model. Okay, in the first step of FEA, what is there? Divide the geometry, given geometry, into finite number of elements. Okay. Hello friends, sir. Why I am using your key point?
Sir,
okay. Okay, 1 minute. Hello? Now? I am audible now? Hello friends?
Voice is breaking.
Yes, sir.
1 minute, actually open the window. Due to that airflow, you may get a thing.
Now it is fine now. Hello friends.
Hello friends. My voice is audible now. Please, because anyone may be active here to respond, but others, please, all of you mute your, because from the participant side, any audio is on, that disturbance is coming in the whole class. Okay, hello, my dear participant, please cooperate me. One of the friend asked the difference between key point and node. Okay, the key point is not belongs to FEA. FEA terminology, I told you, there are only two terminologies there. What is the node and element? Okay, yesterday we solved both the bar and beam problems using node and element. It is not like that. We can also, yesterday problems also solved using the key point. But what to do? Whatever the line, the bar we are taking here, we should divide into number of parts. Okay, we have to, meshing is required actually here. Okay, after geometry model, meshing, it is converted into FEA model. Okay, after dividing, you are getting the node and elements. Okay, now. Okay, because why I'm preferring the key for the beam problem, especially key point means, because all of you know here, what is the severity of the deformations? We won't use the word deformation in the beams. What do you call? The effect, what kind of load is there in the beam? Hello friends, before solving beam problems, I want to clarify first. I think bar means what, you know? Axial load member, each node 1 degree of freedom. Are you agree? But the beam, what kind of load is there here? The load is transverse load. Okay, the load is perpendicular to the axis of the beam. Okay, the transverse loaded members are called as beam elements. Then, each node of the beam, what is the degree of freedom here? Each node, okay, degree of freedom is 2 degrees of freedom. One is linear degrees of freedom, that is going to resist the deflection actually. Okay, opposite to the load. Then another one is moment, the rotation. In the beam, each node is, one is 2 degrees of freedom, one is linear degrees of freedom, another one is rotational degree of freedom. Okay, in the, that is the things, difference between the bar and beam. And the, in the beam, in the bar, the stresses are the direct stress and normal stresses, the tensile compressive nature. But in the beams, you are going to get the bending stress. Okay, it is a bending stress, which is a combination of both tensile and compressive in nature only. And the effect of load, actually not a deformation, you are going to call it deflection here. Because the deflection is severe actually here, the vibration of the Kendler beam you are observing here. Okay, it cannot be linear, you can't show here. That means you can't take only one element, it is you won't get the clear picture actually, the clear shear force diagram and the bending moment diagram. For that reasons, I preferred actually to solve any beam problems. So what to do? Take the key point and line. Then you should add one more extra step, meshing is there actually here. Divide the given line into some 10 equal parts, 20 equal parts or 5 equal parts according to our need. Okay, then after meshing, then it is called as a FEA model. Okay, before solving, we need only FEA model only. I want the element, the model in terms of node and element only. Got it? Your doubt is clear, friends? Hello, friends? Hello, can we yes, can continue?
Yes, sir. Answer clear, sir.
Doubt yeah, okay, clear. Fine. Okay, then, yeah, one of my friend is going to continue. He will solve the problems. I will be here. I'm not going away from the session. Okay, I'm giving the, because he's a friend, he's our alumni only. He's working for a desert company. Actually, he's a design engineer. And I given a platform to explain the, utilize this workshop, how he'll explain. I want to check his capabilities here. Okay, if anything mistake, please cooperate him. I will be here to clear whatever the doubt you are having here. Okay, I'm not skipping here. Hello, friends. Can you cooperate him? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Then node number 2 is there, na? Away from. Node number 2 is 1 meter means 1000 mm. Apply. Then node number 3. This dimension is.
Cross section, you give 0.1 there in the beginning.
Yeah.
0.1 you are given. Hello, friends. One more here. I think all of you observed in the beginning. Hello? I told in the hello, this ANSI software is what actually it is independent of the units. But the who are using the software, he should enter all the values in the either meter or in mm. Okay? My friend, in the beginning, he entered the cross section 0.1, 0.1 actually here. Okay, 10 mm is there. How much? 100 mm?
Yes.
Yeah. 10 mm, 10 mm. There he entered the millimeter unit. But here, length, he can't give the mm here. Are you got it here? Okay. Hello, friends. Then once again, he will rectify his mistake.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. See here, he given here 0.1 meter, 0.1 meter here. 100 mm is there, 100 by 1000. Means 0.1 meters. Then length also, he has to give the meters only.
Meter only.
Yeah. Or he can take directly 100 mm here. Okay, you should follow anyone, either millimeter or mm. Yeah, you can edit it. I told already in the ANSYS, you can you are having fully freedom. You can edit the any value anytime and you can solve it, resolve it any number of times. You'll get the correct answers. Okay? Continue, Eknath.
Node number
3. Hello, friends. Node number. I think here only once again horizontal beam is there. Give only x coordinates. In the voice is not audible, I think. Okay, node number 3 means what? 1 meter plus how much? 1.5 meter. That means? Yeah. Yeah, 2500. Okay, fine. Next. Hello, friends. Now, key points is over. How many key points here I taken actually? 5 key points. Why? At the extreme boundaries, you should take compulsory key points. Then, at the point of loading, 3 kN, second key point is there. Third key point means begin of UDL load. Then, fourth key point is at the end of the UDL load. Okay, and last one is one more point load is there at the free end. Okay, there are 5 key points. Next, what to do? If you've taken the key points, we can't create the elements. Now, you should create the lines only. You should create the lines only. Okay, next we should, after creating no key point, next what to do? Create the lines. Create the lines, straight lines. Okay. Then here, no need to change the attributes here. Why? It is a uniform beam here. Cross section is the same here. And I take a second example, stepped beam. Then you should change the attribute. Okay, now just click the nodes. What happens actually? You got the, created the lines actually. This is a not a FEM model. It is a geometry model. Now, our aim is to convert FEM model into, geometry model into FEM model. Now, I go for the next step. Meshing. Okay, go to the meshing, go for your size control, manual size. Okay, I told the meshing, there are three types, manual meshing, then mapped meshing is there, and third one is auto meshing here. For the 1D problems, you can use the manual meshing only, lines. Okay, then all lines. We can do all lines are the same equal parts, or some small, or can take separate also here. Okay, there are two options that are there. Or picket lines also, you can do it individually. Or you can take the at a time all the lines also. Okay, all lines. Then I can select all the lines, box method. Then take the box, then pick the all lines here. Okay, you can take these options, or pick all option also is there. See here, the first one is what there? Size of the, you can give the meshing by two methods. One is you can, if you know the edge length, you can give the edge length, because you can't use edge length in this case. Why? There are different lines of different lengths are there here. 1 meter, 1.5 meter, like that. Then I can't use the first option here. I can use what actually? Number of divisions. Yeah, 10 divisions. Then okay. Okay, now we divided all the lines into. Then after dividing, then go for mesh, lines. Then you should take the box, click the box and select all the lines. Okay, then okay. And hello friends, now we got FEA model. Okay, earlier what earlier was a geometry model, because why geometry model? You use the options key point and line here. Okay, in FEA I want only node and. Okay, next step what actually, you can go for your naming the node also. Go to the plot, then lines. Okay, then you can see the how it is divided actually here. Then by applying the, now next go to the loading actually here. The first type is displacement load, define loads, apply loads, structural, displacement. Then you are going to apply the key point. Key point is there, na? Yeah, on the key point, select the, it is cantilever beam, only left end is fixed here, select the one left end, okay, RDOF, okay, keep fixed means RDOF. Now, this is over here, this is called essential boundary conditions. By applying the displacement means, because what are the member is there, machine member act as a cantilever beam means what, one end should be fixed here. Okay, next second type of is applying the loads, that is force or moment. Go to the force. You should take here actually. What are the forces there on the key point? You can take. Okay, end of the key point means their color is there actually. Change of color, huh? That is the key point. Then okay. Apply. Then FI here. Vertical is there. Transverse load means perpendicular to the axis. FI. Then yeah, enter the value here. Downward means minus. Minus 3 kilonewton, or you can take 3 E3 also. Okay, kilo means you can take E3. Apply. Okay, and one more point load is there at the end, free end. Select that node. Apply. Then value how much? Minus 2500. Okay, then okay. These are the two point loads. Next, what is there? UDL load is there actually. UDL is there, not a force here, it is a pressure actually, surface load. Then go to the UDL, pressure. Then you can take the on the lines, or you can take the on the beams also. On the beams, where the UDL is there, that region select with the box. Select all the elements. Okay, these are the UDL load I want to apply. Then see here, UDL means what actually? I just want to give the video. UDL means how much actually is there? Second load, how much is there given? Yeah, 1 kilonewton is there. Then only should give the 1000, 1 kilonewton or 1E3. Yeah, for entire load is there. Then both I and J are same here actually. If uniform bearing load is there, it will vary. Okay, I and J value both are same here. Then apply. Yeah. Hello friends,
sir, got it? Load key.
Hello?
What about
the
load key entered
to? Which one? There, na? For UDL. Because.
UDL,
eh? Yeah, yeah. Because that means that the element is there, na? Two row, beam element. There are two nodes is there, na, actually. Left and right here. For UDL, you are entering the two values are there, na? I and J.
Okay
this completes the pre-processing. Hello, friends. Yeah, now I move on to the solution phase now. Go to just solve current LS. Okay, then solution is done. Close it. Okay, now because in the generally beam problems, you are going to draw the SFD and BMD actually here. Okay, and there are some codes are there, SFD and BMD. I can show here, we have used the 188 element. Now go to the actually, you should create the element table because the SFD BMD cannot be drawn. Just wait minutes, I want to copy that procedure, second day. Every time I have to use the mobile to get the data. Now it is there in the screen. I can show both at a time, parallelly. Yeah. Okay, this is the problem is there. Now, I will move on to the next actually. In the how to draw the SFD and BMD. Yesterday, to determine stress and strain, how the ANSYS developer, they give the code LS1, LEPL1. In the same way, to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram, we are having the course actually. I will show now, create element table, define table, add table. Okay, then here no need to give any label actually, directly by sequence number. Okay, SMS 3, apply, then same thing because you should apply some 4 codes actually, is required actually, SMS 6, apply. I will tell you why it is a 3-6, I will show later here, it in the help. Then 16, then apply, then SMS 19. Okay. Okay friends, now close it because these codes are required for to draw the, go to the help actually. I will show here, we have taken the beam 188 element actually, tutorials, you go to the tutorials. I will show here why I have taken this course actually, or you have to buy the things or in the software also it is available here. Now, hello friends, in the tutorial also a lot of problems are there actually here, mechanical APDL tutorials, then actually I want to explain you structural problems, 1 minute, I don't want that, element reference here, element, hello friends, it is visible, element reference, then go to the element library. You go to this element library. Hello friends, yesterday 3D ninne enithadu
do nodu ninin link idre undu 3D
card adella number adalli erli bidu no link sorry beam 188 element. Okay, these are the different elements available to solve the different domain problems. We can't use the elements, structural elements to solve the fluid problems, or we can't use the, because the governing equations are different here. In the structure problems, Hooke's law play important roles, the Newton's law play important roles, in the heat transfer, what actually here? Newton's law of cooling is there, or Fourier law of conductions, or Stefan-Boltzmann law of radiations, okay. The governing equations are different, then element type, the mathematical background is different actually here. Then, hence we should take the beam 188 we use for the today problem to solve the beam problems. Where it is there? 1 minute. Yeah, it's here. Beam 188 element. Hello friends. Because the software that to develop the software, they have to assume lot of the variable names of the to describe the character of the beam element, and they make us assumptions. Lot of assumptions are there here. I'll come to the directly point because getting shortage of time. All of you observe here. This, in this table, what do you find? SF means actually shear force here. What actually? This SF stands for shear force, and y means along the y-axis actually. That means a vertical shear force diagram, and z means horizontal shear force diagram. Okay, two diagrams you can draw. But to see here, SFY is required for me. Then the code is in the next table. Okay, SF means the suction shear force. Then similarly, bending moment. What is the bending moment means? See here, bending stress is there, and MY is here. See here, you want bending moment means actually along the y-axis, because all the transverse load is there, load is acting along the y-axis. I want only MY actually here. Bending moment means vertical bending moment diagram. What is MZ means? Horizontal bending moment diagrams. Generally, if you solve the shaft problem actually, subjected to the various pulleys, the gears, okay, then some inclined pulleys, a lot of vertical force, horizontal force is there. In that case, we should going to draw the both the diagrams, bending moment, vertical bending moment diagram, and horizontal bending. But in this for this beam problem, I want only MOI. Okay, then refer the one more table here, the second table. See here, I want SFY, shear force. Y means the vertical shear force diagram is. What is the code? Tell me, see here. Hello, friends. SMSC 6 and 19. Are you observing here? Please make a note. To draw the shear force diagram, what are the codes used actually here? We need a course, ANSYS course, SMSA 6 and 19. Similarly, I want MY here, bending moment along the y-axis here. MY, yeah, it is there here. MY means, what is the course actually? 2 and 15 here. Hello, friends. Okay, vertical force diagram is 2 and 15. But if you want the horizontal bending diagram, z-axis is what actually? 3 and 16. You can draw both also. You can draw a lot of... Okay, for a given problem, I told na, that is another limitation of FAA is the we design engineers we are faced of what results are required for us. Okay, how to take the decision here, how to take the beam the design is safe, or how much load is going to withstand here, when it is going to fail, what is the life of that beam. Okay, that means we are covering only the what the academic syllabus of the lab syllabus we are going to covering only, but when you are entering the industry. If you want to take design problems, you are going to see here. These are all the different outputs here. Okay, we can find electric strain, direct stress, bending stress. Okay, all the so many you can get. You can find all the unknowns actually here. But for the academic, what the syllabus is there, all our university problems, we are using only that for horizontal force bending moment diagram and vertical bending moment diagram. Then you can draw both means what it actually one more. I can add two more things also here. SFY, shear force. Hello, friend. It is clear actually why you are taking the course. Hello, friends. MY 2 and 15 break. What vertical force of the left? Because we want a shear force diagram. Z and the horizontal bending diagram. Now you can draw the both actually. I told you MY and MZ here. Okay, bending moment diagram along the y axis. That's the vertical bending moment diagram. MZ means horizontal bending moment diagram. Okay, now I'll come to the hello friends. Now in the element table you can add that another two also. Element table, define table, okay, add table by sequence number. Okay, what is required actually? SMSC 2 and 15. SMSC 2 apply, then similarly by sequence number SMS 15. Okay, then fine. Now we can, after creating all this element table, next what to go to do? Go to the plot results. Okay. And here, plot element, deformed and undeformed shape, also you can do it here. You can check it, how it is deformed actually. Okay, this is only deformed and undeformed shape. Next, you can check the contour plot. And the line element results. Now see here, for the vertical bending diagram, what it actually code? SMSC 2 and 15. 2 and 15. This gives the shear force, bending moment diagram. Okay, bending moment diagram for the given problems. You can try the same problem in the using the MOA method. You'll get the same answers. The next, you can also show the SMAS 3 and 19. Hello, 6 and 19 for shear force diagram. Okay. Next, one more thing. Horizontal.
Bending moment,
Z axis. Z axis bending moment. 3 and 16. Okay. but this is a
similar.
Yeah, but because there is no any horizontal force is there, then getting the same bending moment diagram here. But if any beams subjected to the different loadings, horizontal force also given, in that case you'll get the different diagrams. And you can show the animations also. Cross section in a style shape on one,
yeah?
You can make the style go to size and shape, make it on. Okay, then go to the plot. Plot elements, because the area is very less. Yeah, this is the beam. Now we go to the counter plot. Plot control. Animations. Deformed results. Okay. You can get the different. This is only how beam is going to
deflect.
Deflect actually. Okay, Kendler beams are going to. Can you anyone tell me what is the nature of this bending actually? Is it sagging bending moment or hogging bending moment? Hello friends, anybody can you tell me what kind of bending is there? Kendler beams.
Sagging.
Good. Sagging. Yeah. Hagging bending moment. Fine.
Sagging.
Okay. Only simply supported beams are subjected to sagging bending moment. Okay. Okay, like this, you can also, some least results also you can go for actually here in the beams. Generally, the main objective in the lab, you are going to show the SFD and BMD diagrams. And you can show some 3D also, 3D means in the, like this also you can show here. And isometric, then also you can see the animations. Animate, deformed results. Okay, it is some isometric and 3D shapes, you can show it like this. Okay, you can also here list the results, support reaction also you can find it actually. Least results, okay, nodal solutions and DOF solutions, because I told you the beam each node 2 degrees of freedom, one is deflection which resists, another one is moment actually here. I'll show here displacement vector sum and rotation vector sum. Displacement means actually I told here make it horizontal, okay. See the, because how many elements are there, every element you're going to get the actually how much the deflection is there along the y-axis here, because ux and uz zero. Why? Deflection means it will take only on the y-axis, because the load is applied only along the perpendicular the length actually axis here. Y-axis, that is the deflections are going to, at any point of your interest how much deflection is there, you can find it. Or you can get from by color plot also you can going to find. Then rotation, moment, vector sum actually here. Go to the nodal solutions. This rotation vector sum. Okay, these are the, see here. Along Z axis, that means what actually you're going to get the moments actually here. I told here the every beam element, each node is having, one is linear degrees of freedom, that is a resist the deflection. Another one is for every moment there is a equivalent opposite moment is equal actually. Clockwise moment means we want anti-clockwise moment actually, because to keep the beam in equilibrium positions, okay, we need a what actually for every clockwise moment we need an anti-clockwise moment like that. Here only two types of loads are taken actually, only a point load and UDL load. In the next problems we'll take some different loadings. Okay, because first problems I will go a little bit slow actually, then we go for, and similarly you can find the reaction solutions also. Okay, because why Fi only is required actually, why loads are at Newton's third law, for every force equal to opposite force. See, if I add all the force, downward force is equal to upward force here. We take taken the negative, no, all. If I add all the force, then it will be upward force you are getting here. You can cross check. This is the reaction force. And you can also get that values of the all the values, the shear force and bending, we can list the all the values and you will get it here. Select. Okay, these are the values are there, each element, because every one element I've taken 10 divisions actually here. Okay, like that total how many are there? 5 element means 5 tens are 50. All 40. Yesterday 4 elements I think. 4 into, yeah. There are 4 different elements are there. 4 into 10 means 40. Okay friends, this is enough to how to learn that how to solve the beam problems. To especially the aim is to draw a shear force diagram and a bending moment diagram.
Sir,